We are about to discuss an idea that is centuries old and drives many to believe with certainty in the existence of life after death. This idea is currently known as astral projection, where a person is able to leave their physical body at will and take a tour of the entire universe without any physical restrictions. But before you start to project your consciousness out into the universe, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more great content ahead. Alright, so what is this astral projection business all about? Let's take a look at some different points of view, namely the esoteric view and the scientific view, to gain a better understanding of this phenomenon. For many, astral projection or astral travel and the out-of-body experience, referred to as OBE, are often considered to be the same. However, astral projection is a type of OBE that is intentional rather than involuntary. It assumes the existence of a soul or consciousness called an astral body that is separate from the physical body and is capable of traveling outside the physical body throughout the universe. Both astral projection and out-of-body experiences can occur with varying levels of awareness, since this kind of projection of one's soul or consciousness is believed to occur naturally and usually without awareness while sleeping. The complete aware experience of astral projection, though, can be achieved through meditation, relaxation, and hypnosis. This implies that the term astral projection or astral travel can be used to refer explicitly to the experience of leaving the confines of bodily consciousness, allowing one to travel interdimensionally. The projector is always connected to their physical body through something called a silver cord, which can extend indefinitely but always keeps the person attached and brings them back into their physical body. These ideas all fall into esotericism, that can be described as a Western form of spirituality that stresses the importance of the effort to gain spiritual knowledge and confront the divine aspect of existence. The idea of astral travel is ancient and is seen to occur across multiple cultures throughout histories, such as the Egyptian culture, Christianity, Hinduism, Chinese teachings, and more. According to this view, there are different dimensions that occur at different frequencies with different energy levels. In occult teachings, and as held by psychics and other esoteric authors, there are 7 planes of existence. These include the physical plane, the astral plane, the mental plane, the buddhic plane, the spiritual plane, the divine plane, and the logoic plane. However, we will only be looking at astral planes, since astral projection is known to occur only in the astral planes. There are also some sub-levels between these 7 planes which we should understand to get a clear view of astral projection. In terms of energy, the physical plane where we live is described as a dense and limiting place where one can only rely on their 5 physical senses in order to interact with their environment. The next sub-dimension, which is closest to the physical plane, is called the real time zone. This has some properties of physical reality as well as those of the dimensions which lie beyond it. So, the real time zone is kind of like a mirror to the physical plane while also containing some parts of non-physical realities. This is why the real time zone is the dimension in which most projectors find themselves when first learning to consciously project. Immediately beyond or above this sub-dimension, in terms of the standard progression, is the dream plane, which is where dreaming, both lucid and non-lucid, occur. This environment is much more malleable and responsive to the influence of the perceiver than the real time zone or the physical plane. Though there are some differences, the dream plane is often considered part of a larger dimensional descriptor, which is the astral plane, usually referred to in plural form, planes, because there seems to be an infinite number of them. These planes are often described in the standard dimensional terms of higher and lower vibration. These mythicized astral planes are considered to be the home of not only souls finding their way to the next life or final resting place, but also angels and spirits that are more than human. There are 3 main types of astral planes. lower planes, middle planes, and higher planes. In the lower astral planes, which vibrate at a very low frequency, one can expect to find lost souls and demonic creatures. This makes these low frequency planes very dark places to avoid when practicing astral projection. The middle planes vibrate at a higher frequency, making them beautiful places of exploration. All objects in these planes have their own energy emanating out from them, and it is believed that one can perceive past, future, and present events since the concept of time is not the same in these middle planes. The higher astral planes, vibrating at very high frequencies, are beyond comprehension for most people and are referred to as heavens or summer lands by different religious groups. These places are known to be pure and angelic since angels reside in these higher planes. The angels are set to guide those who are able to visit such high frequency astral planes. In terms of the scientific understanding of this phenomenon, currently, we do not have any proof of whether these astral planes really exist. The current research on this topic only relies on anecdotal records of people that are known to practice astral projection because we cannot measure whether a person's soul or consciousness really leaves or enters the body. Since no evidence of consciousness is seen to exist independent of the physical processes in the brain, mainstream science usually rejects the idea of astral projection as proposed by its proponents and practitioners. In order to test the validity of some of the claims made by astral projection proponents, scientists have run some simple experiments in the past. For example, in 1978, a practitioner of astral projection, Ingo Swann, provided a test of his alleged ability to astral travel to Jupiter and observe details of the planet. Actual findings and information were later compared to Swann's claimed observations. According to an evaluation by James Randi, Swann's accuracy was unconvincing and unimpressive with an overall score of 37%. This made Arthur W. Wiggins, a writer on such topics, conclude that astral travel could be an illusion that looks to neuroanatomy, human belief, imagination, and prior knowledge to provide prosaic explanations for those claiming to experience it. Furthermore, according to Bob Bruce of the Queensland Skeptics Association, astral projection is just imagining or a dream state, which agrees with psychologist Donovan Rockliffe's observation that astral projection can be explained by delusion, hallucination, and vivid dreams. Moreover, another researcher, Susan Blackmore, explains that people who experience astral travel have been found to score higher on measures of hypnotizability and, in several surveys, on measures of absorption. This is a measure of a person's ability to pay complete attention to something and to become immersed in it, even if it is not real, like a film, play, or an imagined event. Despite all these scientific findings on the topic, practitioners of astral projection insist that their experiences are real. They insist that there must be these different planes of existence alongside the physical plane where the consciousness or the soul goes after the physical body expires. However, so far, scientifically speaking, we have no evidence of these out-of-body experiences existing outside of the physical brain, let alone the existence of different planes of reality. So what do you think? Do you believe in the existence of consciousness or the soul independent of your physical self? Have you ever projected your consciousness and visited any of the astral planes? If so, we would love to hear it in the comments down below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. Also, let us know your ideas for future topics in the comment section and we might make a video on your idea. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.